Every time you press a button, open an app, or play a video, something behind the scenes decides what happens next. That something is logic. And at the core of it are logic gates, tiny circuits that process ones and zeros to make decisions. From calculators to computers, they're the reason digital devices work. But what exactly are logic gates, and how do they turn simple inputs into smart actions? Let's find out. You've probably heard that digital devices run on ones and zeros, but how do those bits actually do anything useful? That's where logic gates come in. They're the fundamental components inside digital circuits, used in everything from microprocessors and memory chips to calculators and smartphones. A logic gate takes one or more binary inputs and produces a single output based on a specific logical rule. Each gate type, like AND, OR, or NOT, follows a different rule, allowing devices to make simple decisions and perform operations. By combining many gates, complex tasks like math, comparisons, and data processing become possible, making logic gates essential to modern computing. Let's start with one of the most straightforward gates, the AND gate. This gate only outputs a 1 or ON signal when all of its inputs are 1. Think of it like a two-key safe. Both keys must be turned at the same time to unlock it. If even one input is 0, the output remains 0. This makes the AND gate useful in situations where multiple conditions must be true for something to happen. For example, a security system that only activates if two different sensors are triggered simultaneously. Visually, it's often represented with a flat input side and a curved output side, making it easy to recognize in circuit diagrams. Next up is the OR gate, which works a bit more generously than the AND gate. It outputs a 1 if at least one of its inputs is 1. That means the output is only 0 when all inputs are 0. You can think of it like a room with two light switches wired in parallel. If either switch is flipped on, the light turns on. This makes OR gates useful when a system should respond to any one of multiple conditions being true, such as a device that activates if either motion is detected or a door is opened. Visually, the OR gate symbol has a curved input side that narrows to a point at the output, distinguishing it from the AND gate. Next up is the NOT gate, the simplest of all logic gates, but also one of the most important. Unlike other gates that combine multiple inputs, the NOT gate works with just one. Its job is to invert the input. If the input is 1, the output is 0, and vice versa. This makes it incredibly useful in situations where a system needs to respond when something doesn't happen. For example, a NOT gate could be used to sound an alert only when a safety switch is not engaged, ensuring attention when something is wrong. It's also frequently used in more complex circuits to reverse signals, control flows, or build more advanced logic like NAND and NOR gates, which we'll cover later in the video. Now that we've covered the basic gates, let's move on to composite gates, those built by combining the simpler ones. One of the most important is the NAND gate, which stands for NOT AND. It works just like an AND gate at first, giving a high output only if both inputs are high, but then it inverts the result. So the output is false only when both inputs are true. In every other case, the output is true. This behavior makes NAND gates incredibly versatile and widely used. In fact, they're considered functionally complete, meaning you can build any other logic gate or digital system using just NAND gates alone. Because of this, they're a fundamental building block in hardware design, showing up in everything from memory storage to control units and CPUs. Whether you're designing a simple flip-flop or a complex processor, chances are NAND gates are at the heart of it. Next, let's look at another essential combination gate, the NOR gate. It combines the logic of an OR gate followed by a NOT gate. This means it only outputs a 1 when all inputs are 0. If any input is 1, the output is 0. In other words, the NOR gate gives the exact opposite result of an OR gate. It's especially useful in situations where a system should stay inactive unless none of several conditions are true. For example, turning on a backup system only when no other systems are active. Like NAND, the NOR gate is also functionally complete, meaning it can be used on its own to build any other logic gate or digital circuit. This makes it a powerful and flexible component in the design of both simple and complex digital systems. Now let's move on to a slightly more specialized gate, the XOR gate, or exclusive OR. While it may look similar to the regular OR gate, The XOR gate has a key difference. It only outputs a 1 when the inputs are different. In other words, if one input is 1 and the other is 0, the output is 1. But if both inputs are the same, either both 0 or both 1, the output is 0. This seemingly small twist makes XOR gates incredibly useful in situations where detecting differences matters. For example, they're often used in digital comparison circuits, adders, and even in cryptographic systems where two inputs must be compared or combined in unique ways. XOR gates are also essential in half adders and full adders, which are the building blocks of arithmetic logic units and processors. Their ability to detect inequality between bits makes them a vital component in many digital systems that require decision-making based on variation. Now for the final gate we'll cover in this video, the XNOR gate, also known as the exclusive NOR gate. It's essentially the opposite of the XOR gate. While XOR outputs a 1 only when the inputs are different, the XNOR gate outputs a 1 when the inputs are the same. So if both inputs are 0 or both are 1, the output is 1, otherwise, it's 0. This behavior makes XNOR gates useful in systems that need to detect equality between two binary values, such as digital comparators or error detection mechanisms. In digital security, XNOR logic is sometimes used for bitwise comparison between input and stored data. You can also think of it as a way to confirm that two conditions match. While not as widely used as NAND or NOR, XNOR gates still play a key role in specialized circuits where matching signals or symmetry matters. Now that we've explored the main types of logic gates, let's take a look at how they actually show up in real circuits. Logic gates aren't just abstract ideas. They're physically built into tiny chips called integrated circuits, or ICs. These chips often contain multiple gates packed together, ready to perform logical operations in real hardware. Inside each gate, the actual implementation is done using transistors, tiny electronic switches that control the flow of electricity. Whether it's on a breadboard for a simple school project or soldered onto a printed circuit board in a commercial device, logic gates are wired together to control signals, make decisions, and drive digital systems. You'll often see them labeled with numbers like 7400 or 7408, each representing a specific gate type inside the chip. This real-world implementation bridges the gap between theory and the digital devices we use every day. In conclusion, logic gates may seem simple at first glance, but they're the foundation of all digital technology. By combining just a few basic types, like AND, OR, and NOT, we can create everything from calculators to advanced computers. Understanding how these gates work helps demystify the inner workings of modern electronics and gives you a clearer view of how information is processed at its most fundamental level. Whether you're curious about how your phone works or diving into digital design, logic gates are the first step in understanding the digital world. That wraps up our dive into logic gates, the foundation of modern digital systems. If you found it helpful, consider subscribing to our channel and liking the video. Feel free to check out our other videos on related tech topics, and follow us on Facebook and Instagram for more content. Thank you for watching.